talking about aviation, which I am definitely not the expert in, I would let Captain Farah enlighten us that what is her program all about and what made her take this challenge, in fact, I would say, from being a commercial aviation trainer and a pilot. Now, how she is guiding people, what made her take this path? Captain Farah.
Thank you so much, Farah, once again, for this beautiful opportunity. You know, as an airline pilot, we often tend to top the list of most stressful jobs and the professions in the world. Now, that is both in terms of perceived stress and on quantifiable metrics of stress, like rate of burnout and health issues. The basic requirement for the job is a source of stress. And after all, it is the responsibility of the pilot to take the passengers on board to their destination safely. And we have to do this while dealing with and coping with irregular, around-the-clock flying times, jet lag, and you know, major part of our time is spent away from our homes, our loved ones. Now, with all the pressure and the responsibilities, it becomes a must as a crew to not only take care of your physical well-being, but also have an emotional balance. And hence, I have developed my program on stress management in flight crew, which is customized with the powerful tools and effective techniques to help them combat the stress and the fatigue which is accumulated from long hours of flying. And this will help them, you know, create this beautiful balance, which will eventually lead to overall improvement in the quality of life.
This current time is the greatest example, I think, what we have with us, that people, a lot of pilots, the crew members, the entire industry, in fact, is on hold. So a lot of people have lost their jobs, and there is no hope for most of them, in fact, to get their work back. So what is your guidance for them? In fact, I would say, what now is there, what should be their mantra of life now?
Yes, that's a very valid question, especially now during this pandemic, what effect it has created. Aviation is a very high consequence industry. That means when a pilot makes a mistake, the consequences can be catastrophic. Getting back to the question of how do we recover in this scenario, I would like to discuss a very strong ability which one needs to adapt. And before that, you know, as a pilot, we cannot afford to carry the bundle or the baggage of our worries or issues from the past or the present into the cockpit. As a pilot, you train yourself eventually a period of time to adapt to this quality, which is called being resilient. Now, what is resilience? It is bouncing back from the negative experiences. You tend to become more skilled at accepting that the situation has occurred, learn from what transpired, and move on. You know, at the end of the day, what matters in a nutshell is the key to successful emotional growth, which is a must in every field, in every area of your life, is acknowledging your emotions, accepting your emotions, and learning from your emotions. You know, I remember one of my favorites and a very famous ancient African proverb which states, when there is no enemy within, the enemy outside can do us no harm.
And take away that, Captain Farah, you can give, what can be the strategy for the audience which you would like to offer?
Thank you, Shweta. Yeah, I would strongly recommend and request all of you so please don't wait for the change to come to you. Be the change. You know, take one small step towards new direction and respond to the new situation as it unfolds. You know, develop a strategy which suits you the best. And believe me, we all have the ability to create the best version of our life.